I've got one little Bertie looking very stylish in her denim pinafore and white shirt. She's followed by her gorgeous sisters who are behind me with Mummy, who's definitely got her hands full here.
Welcome, Rebecca.
Hello. We're going to plot them down here. So
this could go one of about a million different
You're
ways.
You're going to say hello.
There you go.
Hello to me.
What have you got?
Adorable.
Thank you.
So you have Felix, who's five.
We do.
Felix was a struggle. That was yes. that took longer than you thought, and rounds of IVF. And then miraculously he appeared naturally.
Yes, he did.
And so when it came to having the triplets, equally the same amount of trouble.
Yes, yeah. We decided to give IVF one last try.
Yeah. Mm.
And for the first time it worked, and it worked extremely well, as you can see.
So it did work very well. I mean, you see, first round of, I'm incredibly lucky to have that success then. And you had the blood test done, and it showed up a very, very high level. So they said, oh, this is probably going to be a multiple pregnancy.
They did.
So you're bracing yourself for that, thinking twins.
Yes.
When you found out you were having triplets, how did you feel?
I cried.
Yeah.
And then I had to stop crying because I was going to be sick, triple the hormones.
Yeah.
I remember the overriding thought was for the girls, because I'd had such a beautiful bonding experience with Felix, and that one-to-one time, I was really worried for them. Oh, I won't be able to give them that same experience.
Yeah.
But clearly, they have a different experience that's just really beautiful. They've got each other,
yeah.
And it's wonderful.
But it has been fraught with medical issues. I mean,
really
they arrived early.
Yes.
And the extended stays in hospital.
Yes, yeah. And that was one of the primary concerns that we both had as well in learning that we had a multiple pregnancy. And unfortunately, our concerns did come true when I hemorrhaged at 29 weeks.
Yeah.
And the doctors had said if we hadn't been in the hospital, there wouldn't have been time to save us. And then they spent the first 11 weeks of their life in hospital.
In hospital. And then...
here we go.
So then two of the girls come in. It was Amelie, wasn't it, that had to remain in hospital, and she was there over Christmas. So your first Christmas together as this new family was in hospital with her.
Yes, we went... we gathered the troops and went to visit Amelie in hospital on Christmas Day. So, but people made that very special. You know, you see a lot of kindness in hospitals.
So you've been through it. I mean, there is no doubt about it. And part of your... because you were diagnosed with post-traumatic stress after birth and all those sorts of things. And people deal with things in different ways. And part of your time with bonding with your girls was dressing them.
Yes, absolutely.
And
yeah.
so you started to dress them all the same, and you it's actually a bit of retail therapy at night. Probably
it
got
certainly
a bit
was.
Carried away.
I did.
But you had all these clothes. So why? What was it? How come you decided to go, right, I'm going to do my look of the day?
Well, I think in terms of an ambassador for positivity and fun, I can't think of a better person, Holly. And and it really is representative of this new chapter in our life. We've had lots of beautiful chaos. Clearly, we've had lots of beautiful times, but there has been that cloud hanging over us. And both David and I have said that since we've started Triple the Look, it is at that point that cloud's lifted, and we feel that we are truly just enjoying being a family without worrying about health.
Well, I'm very honoured that your family's chosen me to copy us.
To be dressed like me.
We did, we did try,
yes,
but he wasn't very accommodating, I'm afraid.
He wasn't accommodating.
No, he wasn't very accommodating, but we will try again.
So lots of people following you online. So you're on Instagram.
We are on Instagram.
So if people want to follow you, you are at
Mummy to Triplets and Bro.
Mummy to Triplets and Bro, and then the hashtag is
Triple the Look.
Triple the Look. Okay.
Yes.
Oh,
yes.
And I feel very honoured that they're all dressed the same. I actually got inspired by their look today.
Did you?
So this was the first. We found out what look they had, and I had a choice to choose from, and I was like, well, I think the girls look amazing in their little pinafores. So today, it's been the other way round. They've inspired my look of the day. So.
I kept two of them busy, but I'm sorry I lost one of them.
We lost
you did
one
really
of
well.
I don't know
I think
how.
She's safe somewhere.
Oh, no, she's dead. She's dead.
So daddy.
I don't know how. I just don't know how you do it.
Yeah.
But you say triple the nappies, triple the fun.
I do. Triple the love, triple the smiles. It's wonderful.
And here's Dad.
Hello.
And Bertie's back.
Oh, wow.
Hello.
Oh, wow.
We look forward to seeing what the girls are going to wear in the future. Thank you so much, and send our love to yourself.
How long does it take for you? I don't know whether you... Because I wasn't listening.
No, go on.
So, in case you haven't answered this question, how big is the actual wardrobe? So when Holly rocks up first thing in the morning and does her look, how long does it take? Because you're not just going to find one, you've got to find three.
And you're doing it 7 days a week as well.
We're doing it 7 days a week. I don't think I can answer that question in front of Daddy, Strip Bits and Bry. We'll keep that a secret.
It's big. A finance thing.
It's big. Okay.
Thanks very much. Lovely to meet all of you.